Joe Red is still hanging out.
He's scared of coleslaw. He's scared of coat hangers. He's scared of wardrobes. He's scared of Narnia.
He's scared of potato products. He's
scared of sleeping bags.
He's scared of Pee Wee Herman.
None of that is true.
I used to have
Pee Wee Herman pajamas, and I sleep in a sleeping bag.
He was terrified. Nightmares every night.
I feel like if I had vegetables.
If I had Pee Wee Herman pajamas and I look back on that now, I'd feel weird about that.
Oh, yeah. I do. I think about it every day.
Feel good. I had an Alf sleeping bag. He was scared of that.
Alf?
Yeah.
Dude, Alf was awesome, man.
He was.
He ate cats, right?
He did, which was, you know, a fault to his character.
That was his culture, man.
That's right. You're a big cat guy.
It was cultural differences. You know, I can't fault him for that. You got to meet people where they're at. Like, if I was witnessing to Alf, I couldn't just go up to Alf and be like,
"Don't eat the cat.
Sinner, stop eating cats." Yeah. Because that wouldn't be meeting him where he's at. I'd have to be like, you know, okay, I'm eating with him. He's eating a cat. I'm not eating a cat.
I'm eating a cow. Like,
I see that you're enjoying creation. Let me tell you about Jesus. Yeah. That's how I would approach
like
it.
That.
Just like Paul, you know, I see you have a shrine to the unknown God. Well, let me tell you who that God is. I see you're eating a cat. Let me tell you about Jesus.
Can you please put that on a shirt?
All that?
I see you eating a cat. Let me tell you about Jesus. And then on the back, the rest of the conversation.
Okay, I can.
Please.
I can and will.
Please. And if you do, I want one. I want to be the first.
You'll be the first.
I want to be the first.
No one else
I guarantee you no one will buy it.
No.
I think,
you know what, I think you should hit us up on Facebook, on TBU's Facebook, or email me and let me know if you would buy that shirt from Showbread. I guarantee you. It'll at least be 10 people.
Okay.
10 people. We'll get 10 people.
The order is in. 500, we got it.
Scared of ice.
Scared of cactus. Scared of snakes.
Scared of Alf.
He's scared of Alf.
Are you scared of Alf too?
No,
I'm not. About cats?
No, I'm not scared of cats.
You eat cats?
I like iced tea.
And you like iced tea?
The rapper, not the drink.
He's scared of the rapper iced tea.
All right, so we saw your video coming in at number 2 there. Who decided what to name this video?
Well, that was me. This is I Never Liked Anyone. And those are not my words. It's a line from a book that inspired the song and the video. Just want to put that out there.
I really like
everybody.
It's really hard to remember. Most of the time when our VJs are on TV, they're just like, oh, here's the latest from Showbread.
Well, you know, right before we left, or the first night of tour, an amp broke and we had to drive back home to get another amp. We were nearby. And my dad came out in the middle of the night, having just taken medicine to help him sleep. And he was stumbling outside to help us get this amp. He's like, y'all are on the TVU tonight. With that video, I hate everybody and I'm scared of everybody.
So even your dad is not down on
the medicine wasn't helping.
And the medicine, right, influence. So tell me about the video. Where did you guys shoot it? How long did it take? Tell me all about it.
We shot it in the studio.
Yeah.
While we were recording the record, a friend of ours, Peter, who was just on tour with us, he came out to help us. He did all the neato effects that you see in the video. And it was just the four of us and him through the span of a week getting up and being like, I guess today we'll shoot this part. And Jared, let me tell you, we gave ourselves more than enough time to shoot. We could have shot this in a day, but we spread it out across a week. Yeah. And then somehow we ended up like not giving ourselves enough time. Yeah. And one scene in the video, there's two of me.
Yes.
And one of me has a beard and the other doesn't.
Yes.
So I had to, they were like, all right, now go shave and it'll make the other you look different. So I ran the shave, and then I saw that it would be funny if I had, like, a handlebar, so I ran back and showed everyone, and they're like, it's getting dark, please go shave the rest of your face.
The sun is setting.
This video will not happen.
Any daylight.
Three times
dark.
I came back to show them different versions.
we didn't get all the shots we needed.
Yeah, there was going to be more in it.
Hey, but
You're welcome.
It was funny.
That's awesome. So which one was your favorite? Which versions of your facial hair did you show? Which ones would you like to go back to?
Well, I did one that was like shutters or blinds, you know, like stripes in the sides. And it's not all that thick on the sides, which made it even more confusing. So it was like an optical illusion.
Was it?
Yeah, and it was getting so dark that they're like, we can't even see, so it's not funny. Please, go shave. Yeah. But now it's funny, huh?
Yeah. Is that the first time you've ever grown a beard, Josh? I feel like I've never seen you with like literally a full, like, you had a full.
Well, it takes me a really long time, Jared, you know? My manliness likes to, it's a grower.
Okay.
Literally, it grows on my face.
literally.
So usually I don't like to wait that long. Drew and Patrick, they can grow something pretty nice pretty quickly.
Right.
Garrett, he's faster than me too, but nothing grows on the face of his chin, so it's very Abraham Lincoln-esque.
I can't grow a mustache, and then I can't grow like right here.
And
dude,
we all
being compared to Abraham Lincoln's not a bad thing.
Yeah. It's kind of like a very Amish thing going
neck
on.
Neck beard.
Yeah, I could
but
do
he
that.
Emancipated his face, Lincoln style, and shaved it. The Weir said, let's Lincoln all grow style. Big beards so that we look crazy. In the music video, you know, more crazy-esque or unkempt, if I should say. And we stayed true, the three of us. And Garrett said, oh, my vanity's catching up with me. Emancipation proclamation.
There might be a young lady watching this video. We need to...
I think help. I was the more crazy one because I was willing to be the odd man out.
No,
no, touche. I'm with you.
Definitely not.
All right, so before we let you guys go, you guys are going to be on tour with the band in Kansas.
Yes, we are.
In
just a month or so.
And the wedding, right? That's good.
That's right.
You got anything special planned for that tour?
You know, I plan on sabotaging those two bands as much. I haven't even met a band in Kansas yet, and I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm gonna make it miserable to be on tour with Showbread.
They got it coming.
Every night they're gonna be like, if we can leave sooner so that our van doesn't end up with, you know, cat poop in it or something like that, then that would be nicer, and they're gonna live in fear.
Oh man.
All right, that's what you have to look forward to, a band in Kansas. I'm excited about that tour, actually. Where can you get details on that? When does that kick off? Do you guys know?
Well, we finish this tour in another couple weeks, and then that tour starts almost immediately afterwards. And on any one of our websites, you can get all the dates and come check us out.
Yeah.
Cool.
Showbread.net.
Guys, thanks for hanging out with me on the show today. It's always a pleasure.
Hey, thank you.
It's been very fun.
Hey,